Hey guys, Hunter Britt with CrossFit Invictus. I'm gonna explain to you the bamboo bar setup. Obviously it's not a bamboo bar. We use a PVC pipe, it's a lot cheaper. You can go to Home Depot and get it for a few dollars, save yourself a lot of money. So overall, setup for this, I wanna explain my favorite way to set it up and then also ways to make it either easier or harder depending on your ability with it. The nice thing is you get much better at this pretty fast. So give it a few times and you'll start feeling really comfortable. So how I like to set it up, I like to always double the band over. So if I take the band, my little figure eight, and I put it together, obviously it's half the length now, and then I'll reach through and put the band on the bar just like that. All right, just be careful when you're always loading the bar because you put one on one side, this is light, so it'll just slip off. So just have someone else help you set up for it. Ways to make this harder for yourself, if you find that it's not much of a challenge, is I prefer people to add multiple kettlebells with their bands. If you have just one band holding a lot of weight, it'll tend to just bounce a lot or stretch the band out too much. You won't get a whole lot out of it. So multiple kettlebells with less weight sometimes is harder than just one heavy weight on one single band. All right. If you're at a point where you're also lifting and the band, it's not really challenging as far as you're getting tired because you're pressing it, but it's not trying to shake very much. You're not really getting the stimulus out of a bamboo press or bench press, whatever you're doing with it, that you could be. All right, so this is mostly working on those smaller muscles, stabilizing the shoulder. It's really good for rehab and prehab and warming up as well. So make sure there's some kind of challenge in there as far as shaking back and forth and having to control that. Obviously, I don't want you out of control, but it should be giving you a little bit of resistance that way. So when you're doing this, all right, nice and controlled reps is what I'm looking for. So I don't want to see a lot of like bouncing at the bottom because then obviously the bands will start bouncing up and down. So control all the way through. All right, sometimes it's nice, just move nice and slow. And then if you're getting really tired, maybe you start need to get some reps in, just get a hold up top. It's also still a lot of work up there to hold. All right, obviously if you're at this point and it's not shaking much, I would want to add another band and kettlebell to this to make this a little more challenging. All right, I hope that helps and enjoy giving this a shot.